Hello students, welcome to Wisdom Academy. I am Nasreen and today we will be seeing hybridization from chemical bonding and molecular structure. Okay, so what is hybridization, then what is the condition to form hybridization, and what are the special features of this process? Okay, so first we will see what is hybridization. So what is hybridization is atomic orbitals, okay, will intermix with themselves to form a new orbital. Atomic orbitals intermix with themselves, okay. The intermixing will have some conditions, we will see, okay. So the atomic orbitals will intermix with themselves to form a new orbital. So this is called hybrid orbital, okay. So this process is called hybridization. You already heard about this word hybrid in biology and also in some vegetable shop also. They will say hybrid potato, hybrid tomato. What are things is they produce with some new concept or some new genes. Okay, so this is called hybridization. So hybrid orbitals are produced by some other atomic orbitals. So atomic orbitals intermix to form new orbitals. Okay, so which is called hybrid orbital. This process is called hybridization. Now we will see what are the conditions. Not every atomic orbital will intermix with themselves. Okay, for example, we have valence shell orbitals are hybridized. For example, we have, if there is a nucleus, okay, so atoms will have inner shells, then only valence shell will be there. Okay, so only this valence shell will participate in hybridization. The inner shell will not participate. Okay, so the valence shell, okay, the orbitals in the valence shell will participate in the hybridization. The inner shell orbitals will never participate. Okay, so this is the first point. Next point, orbitals, the intermixing the valence orbitals should have almost equal energy. For example, if we have four types of orbitals, S, P, D and F. Okay, S never overlaps with D because the energy difference is very, very high. S never overlaps with F. Here also energy difference is very, very high. But S can form a hybrid with P because it has quite equal energy. P can bond with D. Okay, so S can overlap with P, P can overlap with D. But S and D cannot form, S and F cannot form because energy difference is very, very high. Okay, so they should have utmost equal energy. It's not really exactly equal. Utmost equal energy is acceptable. Okay, so this is regarding second condition. Third condition is promotion of electron is not essential. So when hybridization is taking place, you no need to see whether electron can go there or not. Any other extra conditions regarding electron, we don't need to worry about it. Just concentrate on the overlapping of electrons, but overlapping of orbitals only. Okay, the next one, even fully filled orbitals can take place in hybridization. For example, we have xenon. Okay, we always know fully filled is highly stable, it will not react with any other molecule. Okay, but xenon is quite reactive. It is not highly reactive, it is quite reactive at drastic conditions. Okay, so this is a fully filled, xenon is fully filled, right? So 2, 8, 8, 8, so this is a fully filled orbital only, but this also sometimes participate in hybridization. These are the four conditions. They should, valence shell orbitals only should participate, energy should be almost equal, promotion of electron is not essential, even sometimes fully filled orbitals also participate. Okay, so these are the conditions for hybridization. Now we will see what are special features of hybridization. Okay, so number of hybrid orbitals will be equal to number of atomic orbitals. For example, two atomic orbitals is participating, we will get two molecular orbitals, two hybrid orbitals. Okay, the number of atomic orbitals is equal to number of hybrid orbitals. If we take two atomic orbitals and hybridization of them, we will get two hybrid orbitals. Okay, so next one, hybrid orbitals have equivalent energy and shape. So the two hybrid orbitals which is formed will have utmost equal energy and equal shape also. Okay, so they will not be, one will be like this and one will not be like this. Okay, the hybridization will always give you orbitals or hybrid orbitals with equal energy and shape. The next one, form stable bond. Okay, compared to atomic orbital, molecular orbital will form a stable bond. This is an important feature. Okay, so that's when only atoms forms molecule, because orbitals in molecule will be forming a stable bond compared to atomic orbitals. Then directed in space for minimum repulsion. This is a very important point. Like for example, I having an atom, it is forming a bond with other atom. Okay, so see here, three can form even this way also. Okay, but here the angle is approximately we can take 60 degree, okay, but here the angle is 180 degree, okay. So which is it more greater angle is 180 degree is greater, okay. So greater angle means they are far apart from each other, they are very very far, right? So this is very far from this one, but here this is quite near, okay. So why they are far means, see, this also has electron, this also has electron, electron electron will repel each other, so there will be repulsion, okay. Whenever we need a stable molecule, repulsion should be less, okay. So in order to minimize repulsion, there will be some orientation space. It should be 180 degree, 60 degree, 80 degree, 90 degree. Some angle will be given, some orientation will be given, okay. So this orientation will give you geometry. What is geometry? Is shape of the molecule, like how it look like. It look like linear or triangle, square, rectangle, okay. What is the shape is given by this direction in space, okay. It will always direct itself to the space where less repulsion will be there, okay. This direction will give you the special geometry of the molecule, okay. So these are the features. Number of hybrid orbital should be equal to number of atomic orbital. Hybrid orbital should have equal energy and shape. They form stable bond. They will be directed towards in space for minimum repulsion. So this direction will give you the geometry of the molecule. So this is the features of the hybridization. So now we will see types of hybridization. We have many types of hybridization. Basic is three basic hybridization, okay. SP, SP2 and SP3 hybridization, okay. So now we will start with SP hybridization. What is SP? Is 1s overlaps with 1p, okay. For example, S overlaps with pz, okay. So when S overlaps with 1p, the hybridization formed, the hybrid orbitals formed by the process of SP overlapping, okay. So 1s overlaps with 1p, it is also called diagonal hybridization, okay. So now whenever you are writing hybridization, you have to tell S character and p character, that is how much percentage of S is present, how much percentage of p is present, okay. Here we have only two orbitals, one is S, one is p, okay. So what is S is 50%, p is 50%, 50% S, 50% p, okay. So next, what is the angle between them? Is the molecule formed will have the angle 180 degree, shape is linear, okay. So for every hybridization you have particular angle, particular shape, okay. For SP, angle is 180 degree, shape is linear in shape, okay. So we take an example of beryllium chloride. So beryllium chloride valence shell is 2s2, its bonds hybridization formed with chlorine, valence shell is 3s2 3p5, okay. Chlorine will need only one electron. Beryllium 2s2, this is 2s, this is 2p, okay. 2s2 arriving as it is called ground state, but for forming a hybrid orbital, forming a bond, it has to go to excited state. In excited state, pairing will be unpaired, okay. So this is excited state, we have one pair, it will be unpaired, two will come, okay. So this one electron will go to the p orbital. So here one is here, so yes. So now where the chlorine is coming and attacking the boron beryllium electron is one electron S, another electron is P, okay. So 1s 1p, hence it is called SP hybridization, okay. So this is regarding the arranging the electron. Now we go to shape, okay. When S overlaps with 1p, this is a new hybrid orbital we get, okay. So when S overlaps with 1p, the shape of orbital will be something like this, okay. Chlorine shape will be normal shape, only beryllium is undergoing hybridization, that shape will be different, okay. So see, so chlorine has a dumbbell, this has a dumbbell, head on collision is happening. Whenever head on collision happens, head on collision only will happen because this is the first bond forming. I already told you in class of hybridization, sorry, in overlapping, whenever the first bond is forming, it is always a sigma bond, okay. So here one sigma bond is formed, here one sigma bond is formed, okay. So beryllium look like this, okay. This is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, shape is linear, angle is 180 degree. So this is for SP hybridization. Same we have something called SP2, okay. SP2 means 1s overlaps with 2p, for example S overlaps with pz and py, okay. So two overlapping, so again percentage, see we have 3, so divide by 3, 1 divide by 3 is S, 2 divide by 3 is P, because 1s we have 2P, 1 divide by 3 approximately turn into percentage, it is 33.33, 3, 2 by 3 into percentage is 66.66%, okay. So this is the percentage of S and P, angle is 120 degree, trigonal planar. How will you remember the angle is, whenever you have 2, it is always straight. Whenever you have 3, 3 will form a triangle. Okay, so it is trigonal planar, angle of triangle is 120 degree. Okay, so this is 120 degree trigonal planar. We take example BCl3. Okay, for boron 2s2 2p1 chlorine normal valence shell. For boron 3 electron is there. This is s, this is p3. This is ground state. For excited state, unpairing should be done. So it is unpaired. Okay, so now chlorine comes here, here and here. We have 3 chlorine, right? 3 chlorine is occupied. The blue dot represents chlorine. So s P2. In 2P, the hybridization is taking place. So this hybridization is called sp2 hybridization. Okay, again, so this black colored is the hybrid orbital which is formed. Okay, so this red color is the chlorine. First time bond is forming, so all the 3 bond will be sigma bond. It look like this. Sigma bond, sigma bond, sigma bond. Okay, so the shape is trigonal planar, angle is 120 degree. Okay, so next we'll move to sp3 hybridization. 1s overlaps with 3p. Okay, so S plus PX plus PY plus BZ. Okay, so this is the overlapping. So we have 25% of S, 75% of P. Okay, the angle is 109.5 degree. Shape is tetrahedral. Tetrahedral shape is like this. Okay, 1 will be above this. Okay, the 3 will be below, like a pyramid. Okay, so this is called tetrahedral shape. This is the then carbon valence shell is 2s. We take methane as example, 2s2 2p2. Okay, we have 4 electron. So in hybrid is a hybrid, this is ground state. In excited state, unpairing should be done. So we have 4 electrons. So we need 4 hydrogen to bond with carbon. So 4 hydrogen is there. Okay, so we have, this is the hybrid orbital of carbon. 4 hydrogen has only S, right? Shape of S orbital is spherical. Spherics we have put. Every time first time bond is forming, so all the 4 bond is a sigma bond. So sigma, 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 sigma. Okay, so this is regarding sp3 hybridization. Okay, so sp1s1p, okay, sp2 1s2p, sp3 1s3p. okay, 180 degree linear, 120 degree trigonal planar, 109.5 degree tetrahedral. Okay, so then is 50% s, 50% p, 33.3% s, 66.7% p, 25% s, 75% p. So these are the basic things you need to remember. Okay, then hybridization, ground state, excited state, don't get confused. Ground state you have to write as it is in the electronic configuration. Excited state you have to unpair every electron. You have to make sure that every electron is unpaired. Okay, so we have to unpair electron, then we have to put how many atoms are bonded. 3 chlorine means I will put 3 dots. Okay, so this is the thing. You have to remember the hybrid orbital structure. Okay, the chlorine hydrogen structure will be same because they are not undergoing hybridization. Only the central atom is undergoing hybridization. That structure you need to remember. Okay, so this is regarding 3 types of hybridization. So now we will see some special type of hybridization. Okay, so we have seen sp, sp2 and sp3. Now we will see beyond sp3. Okay, for example, we have phosphorus. Phosphorus valence electron is 3s2 3p5. Okay, so we have this electron, sorry, 3p3. So total we have 5 electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. S2P3. Okay, so this is ground state. But we have only 3 unpaired electrons, but we have 5 chlorine. For 5 bonding atoms, you should have 5 unpaired electrons. Okay, so we are going to unpair this also. So after this P, it will have empty d orbital. It will have empty d orbital. Okay, so just unpair it. So I have 5 unpair. I have 5 unpair. So 5 chlorine will come and bond with phosphorus electrons. Okay, so this is called hybridization, right? So where are the hybridization taking place? 1s, p3 and 1d. Okay, so this is the hybridization of PCl5. So using this you can calculate the hybridization. Okay, so instead of doing all those molecules, everything, you can simply use this. Then we have sulfur, SF6. Sulfur is again 3s2 3p4. So this is the ground state, but we have 6 fluorine, so we need 6 unpaired electron. I am unpairing everything. So I have empty d here also. 1 2 3. Okay, so I have 6 unpaired electrons. So where are the hybridization takes place? All the fluorine will come and join with this unpaired electron. 6 fluorine is there. So S, P3 and D2. So this is the hybridization for SF6. For the given molecule, write the configuration, unpair the things which is required unpaired electron which is required and fill it. Okay, so the hybridized orbital will be giving you the hybridization of the molecule. So this is regarding hybridization beyond sp3d, etc. For any molecule you can write hybridization. One thing you have to know is you have to make sure that you know the electronic configuration of the element. If you make mistake here, the entire thing will go wrong. Okay, so now we will see the formation of, we have seen sigma bond formation everywhere, okay, in sp, bcl2 bcl3, everywhere sigma bond was forming. Now we will see with sigma bond how pi bond is formed. Okay, so okay, first we will take a molecule called ethene. Okay, two carbons are there, four hydrogen equally share the hydrogen, so two hydrogen for each carbon. Okay, now carbon will share a first bond, that is sigma bond. So only three valency is satisfied, carbon has valency four. So the one more bond is formed, which is pi bond. The bond which is formed over sigma bond is called pi bond. Okay, now we will see how does it look. Okay, so carbon configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So 2s2, 2p2 is outermost, 2s2, 2p2. Okay, so this is ground state, excited state is, so this is the excited, so everything is unpaired. Okay, so we have two carbon, this is carbon 1, this is carbon 2. Excited state is same for every carbon atom. Okay, so first we will write for hydrogen, each one have two hydrogen, 1 2 1 2, so hydrogen is done. Now this carbon first share a single bond, this is a single bond, then above that it forms a double bond. So this is how bond is formed. Now we will look into hybridized diagram. Okay, carbon hybridization look like this one. This is a hybridized orbital of carbon. Carbon 1 and this is carbon 2. Okay, so here sigma bond is formed. Okay, and here one hydrogen is forming, and here one hydrogen is there. Here one hydrogen and here one hydrogen. Okay, so H2 is done. H2, sigma bond is done. Now we have to fill pi bond. Okay, so pi bond, see, we have two types of lobe. One lobe we have like this, one lobe we have like this, one lobe we have like this. Okay, this three combined to form this hybrid orbital. Okay, so here, see, in this only sigma bond is formed. Okay, so we have this two type. Either I have to take this type or this type. I am taking this axis. Okay, so this overlaps with above the plane, there is one overlapping. Below the plane there is one overlapping. Okay, two overlapping will form only one sigma bond. You should not confuse, it forms two pi bond. Okay, two overlapping will form only one pi bond. So this two overlapping forms another pi bond. Okay, so this has two overlapping, above the plane one overlapping is there, below the plane one overlapping is there. So two overlapping will give you only one pi bond. So this is regarding CH2. Another molecule we can go, that is ethyne. Like C2H2. Okay, so again we have two carbon, each one has one hydrogen. Okay, so first one formed will be sigma bond, then is pi bond, another bond should be formed pi bond because valence is 4, right? So 1 2 3 4, so here two pi bond is formed. Okay, as usual I'm directly writing excited state. So this is excited state for C1, for C2 this is excited state. So each one has one hydrogen. So this form is sigma bond, another one is pi bond, another one is pi bond. How many bonds it made, it doesn't matter. Okay, the bond which is formed over sigma bond is a pi bond. Okay, so we have two pi bond here. Now we will go to hybrid orbital diagram. This is the hybridized carbon diagram. Okay, here sigma bond is formed, here we have one hydrogen, here we have one hydrogen. Okay, so again we are left with this type and this type. Okay, so this will form an overlapping pi bond, this will form one pi bond. See, this is forming one pi bond, so above one overlap, below one overlap, this is one pi bond, this is forming the second pi bond. Okay, so there are four overlapping will give you two pi bond. Okay, so we have two pi bond here. This is regarding sigma bond and pi bond formation. Okay, so this is the overall concept of hybridization we have seen. So yeah, that's it. So like this video, subscribe to our channel, share with your friends. Thank you.